It was nice to have someone to talk to. They don't sit with me at the canteen, he was saying. I feel like they're avoiding me. It's not my fault I'm a wild elf. I was born this way. Sure, I'm a little bigger than the rest of them, and, okay, clumsier. But that doesn't make me a bad elf. See, a bad elf would be the sort of elf that just left you out there in the cold. A good elf wouldn't do that. Having devoured the portion of reindeer milk, the animal let out a long yawn and nestled its head on Alabaster's lap. The only question is, where are you going to sleep? Alabaster glanced around in search of somewhere suitable, then attempted to pick up the creature by the scruff of its neck. As he did so, Fluffy dug its claws into the upholstery. When Alabaster finally succeeded in prizing it off, he almost fainted in horror to see the deep scratch marks that now exposed the cushion's white cotton innards. Each scratch looked like it had been sliced with a cutthroat razor. Fluffy's claws would need a good clipping if he was to keep his furniture intact. Tomorrow, it was already getting late. The cubbyhole under the stairs was probably the best place for now. Alabaster folded a towel for a bed and strung up some fairy lights to make the den feel a little more homely. With careful hands, he placed the animal on the towel, then added a cushion and a bowl to do its business in case it woke up in the night. "Night, little fella," he soothed as he pulled the door closed. The creature blinked at him, confused. Then it began to cry. Ignoring the animal's whimpers, Alabaster trundled up to bed. The clock on the bedside table read 11:57. Throughout the house, a shrill, ear-splitting noise honked with the volume and insistence of a car alarm.